Now, the pandemic is taking a heavy toll on the mental well-being of all of us, I think is safe to say, and especially on the school systems, educators, and students. ABC4's Nicole Newman has that story.
We knew that stress would be on the rise.
Dr. Sydney Dixon, the Utah State Superintendent of Public Instruction, details the struggles of the past 10 months for school systems. During a mental wellness webinar today, Dixon listed the four major hurdles teachers and students are facing. They include economic loss, increased social and emotional stress and trauma, low to no broadband access, and community virus spread.
We have eyes on our kids when they're in school. When they're not in school, we know that things are happening in their home.
Throughout the pandemic, schools have shifted from an in-person to an online learning model, and sometimes both. Salt Lake City School District is the one district in the state that was strictly online since the pandemic began. That was until this week. Elementary school students returned on Monday.
I would say that if you ask any teacher right now, we're exhausted.
Holly Reynolds is a social studies teacher at West High School in Salt Lake City. Last semester, she taught 160 students.
You're trying to deal with personal things, and then you're also trying to be this like support for a mass group of students.
The responsibility comes as she and other teachers are trying to ensure they're healthy, as well as the well-being of their families.
It's hard to juggle all of that.
Middle and high school students in Salt Lake City returned back to the classroom for in-person learning on February 8th. In the newsroom, Nicole Newman, ABC 4 News.